Hi, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. I am Susan Lynn. I'm a psychic and a medium, and I am really excited to share with you something new today. And that is, I discovered through a friend how to take pictures of spirit. Now, there's lots of ways you can take pictures of spirit. Of course, you can see orbs and different things like that. And you can have different cameras, and you know, you can get very detailed about it. You know, you can really dive in, but I'm going to tell you how to do it with your cell phone. And I'm going to tell you that anybody can do it. Yes, you can take pictures of spirit. I took a picture of my little dog over there from my childhood. A little schnauzer appeared in this way for me to photograph. So how did I do it? How do you do this? Let me tell you, it's so simple. I'm going to go through some of the things right now. Let me first say that there are no hard and fast rules. The only thing I would say is you have to take a lot of pictures, number one. The best practices that people have suggested so far have worked for me, so I'm going to give you those things. But once you try that, you honestly can, you can broaden your horizons. You can photograph spirit in so many different ways. So, but just to start, I'm going to introduce how I was taught to do it. And I have had success in it, right? All you do is set your intention, maybe do a prayer, clear your space, you know, do white light protection, invite good spirits, good energies to come down and co-create with you. So that's number one. You want to clear your space. You want to make sure that your energy is good. However you do that is fine. Burn sage, whatever works, right? Okay, second of all, you need a camera. A cell phone is perfectly fine. Doesn't have to be new, doesn't have to be old. You can use any camera you want. I just find cell phones are very easy to use. Second of all, according to the things that I did to get my photos, this is what I used. I used a black bowl. This is a bowl, you know, just a regular plastic bowl, not too big, not too small. It doesn't really matter. You could do this with a big bowl, a little bowl. You could probably even do it with a bowl that's not black, but this is just what they suggested, and this is what I've used, and I've had some success with it. In the middle of the bowl, you should put something shiny. I've put aluminum foil here. My first couple of times, I didn't even tape the aluminum foil to the bottom of the bowl. The foil was just floating around, and I still got photos. That's how I got the photo of my little dog. But it's irritating to me, so I just put some scotch tape and taped it to the bottom of this bowl, okay? I know you guys are going to have a million questions, and I'm going to answer this. Just bear with me. Okay, you put water in here. Enough water that you can move the water around. The person who told me how to do this was using a popsicle stick, because when you have your bowl sitting on the table and you have your popsicle stick and your camera, it's just easy to not get the agitating thing, the popsicle stick, in the photos. I didn't have one. The first time I did this, I used a straw, a plastic straw. Worked pretty well. Actually, I got a couple of good photos that way. But I threw out my plastic straw, so I had to go back and find something else. As I was rummaging through all the drawers in the kitchen, trying to find anything that would be small but would agitate water, I saw this. This is a cheese. This is not small. This is a cheese knife, and it has a real pretty shell kind of shape to it. And somebody said, "That's pretty. Use that." It wasn't me. So I said, okay, you know, I'm figuring if I'll use what you want to use as long as you jump in the photo, let's make a deal. So we made a deal. So water in your bowl, agitator, and just agitate the water. Okay. So the bowl is sitting on a flat surface. You have the agitator and you have your phone in your other hand. You're not going to see the spirit. You're not going to see it. You're just going to go click, 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 click. You're going to take picture after picture after picture. And when you've taken 20 or literally 20 pictures, you're going to look at them. And then you're going to see if you caught spirit, okay? Some of these people do this, shoot 100 photos before they get one that they like. But I know the reason why they do that now is because they're looking for the amazing photo, the photo that you literally is such a likeness that you could say, that's my grandfather, right? What I got was pretty good. I think my schnauzer was pretty good, definitely recognizable to me as my dog. I got a picture of another guy that I don't know who that is. He sort of looks like my spirit guide, Sam, so he might be that person. But then as I started doing more, because this is addictive, it's addictive. You will be in your room with the water you'll be doing this all the time. I started getting other pictures. I got eyes, very clearly defined eyes. I got different kinds of faces. And you can see in the photos how they're trying to come through, right? So the first might be an eye, and then the eye moves over here, and then you see an eye and a nose. And you can see them trying to blend their energy with the energy of the water and your energy, right? It's a blending kind of thing that happens. And you can see it when you look at the photos, especially if you can pull them up on your computer screen where you can see them in sequence. You know, like on my iCloud, I can pull up what looks like a contact sheet if you were an old photographer back in the film days. So basically all the photos are lined up together and you can literally see the progression of how the face appears. It takes like three photos, you know, tap, 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 very quick, right? For the face to actually come all the way through. So it's really fascinating. Really fascinating. So once again, I want to go over the instructions one more time because I left something out. So hopefully you're still watching. Okay, you're going to need a phone. You're going to need some sort of bowl. Okay, I did try this with a different kind of bowl. It didn't work quite as well. So a dark bowl would be best. A red bowl, a dark blue bowl. Put something shiny in the middle, tape it down if you want. Have something to agitate your water, okay? So you're gonna agitate the water, just like this while you're taking the pictures. The thing that I left out is you need a light source. So I have a light source connected here. I'm gonna see if this will work. That is my light source. That's what I use to do my videos. And I just tilt that down to my bowl. Now, I know for a fact that people have gotten very good photos with a lamp, just like taking a table lamp and leaning it over and propping it up so that it's shining straight down into the bowl. I know people have used flashlights. This requires some ingenuity because you'll have to find a way to prop the flashlight pointing down into your bowl, right? So, but you know, it's fun. It's part of the process, if you ask me. So you do need a light because these spirits come out as gray. You know, they come out as black and white. And if you don't have enough light, you just can't see them, right? So I'm going to also say that you can photograph this once you start doing this, you can see spirit in everything. You can see spirit in a reflective surface like this. Like you don't see it now, but you take 20 photos and there's one in there. After you really get used to working with spirit, they will co-create with you all kinds of places. In steam, some people use steam, they use tea kettles. They use hand steamers. There's a really fun thing that's going on right now. People are using their glasses. They're taking their phone and photographing their glasses. And then when they look at the glasses, when they look at the picture, there's a spirit in there. And I'm telling you, the spirit is very well formed. It's like a actual photograph of the spirit. It's amazing, you guys. It's amazing. So for me, when I started doing this, I got the picture of my dog. I got the picture of what I think kind of looks like my spirit guide, as I picture him. And then I started getting pictures of faces. But they weren't, not sure they were human. I'm not sure that they weren't alien. I'm not sure what they are, or maybe they're not fully formed. I'm not sure. But that's part of the interesting fun of this exercise is you start to realize that there's energies all around you, right? If you're in a protective sphere and you're calling on good energies, they're good energies. They may not look like you or me. They might not be coming through like you or me, but there they are. So that's very interesting too, I think. But I think this is fascinating, and it's certainly a really fun hobby. So hopefully you guys will try this with your cell phones. Leave me questions in the comments. I will try to answer them. And if you get a picture, email me your picture at susanlynmedium@gmail.com, because I want to see it, and I'll put it on YouTube for all of us to see it too. This is going to be fun. I think you're going to really enjoy it. Remember, you have to take a lot of pictures. Some people take 50 pictures before they get one thing. And even if you just see an eye or an ear, that's them trying to come through. So count that as something. Count it. Even if you're looking at it and you're going, oh man, I don't know that if that looks like a face. Maybe I'm just making this up. I'm going to tell you that you're not making it up, because all you got to do is go two previous frames over, and you'll see that the water's in a different shape and that disappeared in the same place, right? I mean, it wasn't there two frames ago, but now it's there, right? It's them. It's spirit. That's part of the process of awakening, right? Is allowing, is accepting, is just being open to it. So I think this is another exercise you can do too, to open yourself up to this. You don't need to be a medium to do this. A lot of these people that are doing this are not mediums. They're just interested in metaphysics, and they're just open enough, and spirit comes in and co-creates with them to create photos. So hopefully you find this interesting, fascinating. Hopefully you'll try it, because I really want to see everybody's pictures. And I just want to thank you again for viewing this video, for supporting my channel, for just being awesome people. You guys are the best. I'm not kidding. Please subscribe. If you like this content, please subscribe, because I'll be providing more content. I am going to do some more political videos, but I just need to take a break from time to time. As an empath, the political system, the places where we're at right now can be very draining. I encourage you as well to take a break from the news. It's not good for us. It is not good for us. I'm not abdicating anything. I am very much still involved in writing. My congressmen, my senators, believe you me, they know who I am. I am very much encouraging of them to change their ways. So I'm not literally disappearing from my role as my civic duty, right? But I am taking a break from some of the bigger picture things that I just can't, I don't, there's nothing I can do about, right? There's just nothing I can do about these things. I can pray for them. I can do the Ho'oponopono. If you look at the video that I just did, the Ho'oponopono prayer, I can lift up my state. I can lift up people. And then I have to let it go. We have to let it go. This is really starting to make us tired, sick, and angry. That's why it's important to do fun things like play with spirit, play with your abilities, play with the tarot, play with oracle cards, play with crystals, do some other things to really raise your vibration and bring yourself up, okay? Because too much politics is just, it's just damaging right now. It's very damaging. So hopefully this has been helpful for you guys. Love to you all, okay? Just big love to all of you. Thank you again for joining me. I really appreciate it. I am starting a Patreon channel. That's a whole nother topic that I will do a video about. It's going to be a separate place where members can go to get more content that they're really interested in. So if you're interested in what I'm doing right here on YouTube, stay with me on YouTube, because you're going to get more of it. I love this channel. I love this group of people. I'm growing it. I'm grateful. So you know what? We're all on a wonderful journey together. Thank you again. Take care, everybody.